you have four states of consciousness. Understand, first, the state in which you are there now, wakeful state. We call that as a Jagrat. I think most of you are in the Jagrat state. Hope. Now, whoever has smiled, you are all in Jagrat state. If you are still waiting to smile, then don't bother yourself too much, relax. At least be in the state in which you are. Waking state, the wakeful state, we call that as a Jagrat. In Jagrat state, in wakeful state, you will have the feeling, I means the identity and flowing thoughts. You will have thoughts also. You will have I and thoughts. Second thing, second state is dream state. Understand? In dream state, your thoughts frequency will be much more stronger than the identity I. That is why in the dream state you can't control your thoughts. That is why you can't have your own dreams. If you have the freedom to choose your own dreams, you know what kind of dreams you will always choose. It is not in your control, because the identity I, the I's frequency will be lesser than the thought's frequency. That's a dream state. I'll show you a small chart and explain. Third state is deep sleep. In the deep sleep state, you will neither have the identity I nor have thoughts. The fourth state is Turiyavastha, Samadhi, enlightenment. That is the state you have never experienced. In that state, you will have a strong, clear feeling that you exist, but there won't be any thought. This is very difficult to comprehend. You existing without any thoughts is very difficult for you to comprehend or understand, because you never experienced that moment. You never experienced you without any thoughts or upadhi, identities, any association. You always experienced you only with some thoughts. The moment you say, I am, already your mind has started thinking, you are a male or a female or a doctor or engineer or lawyer, you are intelligent or fool. Usually we don't believe we are intelligent. We may tell others, but we ourselves don't believe. We ourselves don't believe. What we tell others, never think you believe. You don't believe that. You may tell something to others about you, but what you believe will be totally different. The already you associated yourself with some upadhi, with some identity, with some idea. You never experience that you exist without having any thoughts. If you experience that precious moment, you existing without any thought, you are enlightened. You don't need body and mind. Then suddenly you realize you exist even when you don't have body and mind. When you experience you exist even when you don't have body and mind, the death fear disappears. See, fear of death is nothing but what will I do without this body and mind? Where will I be? How will I be? The fear of unknown is the fear of death. When you are clear that you exist even while you don't have body and mind, you become enlightened. That is what happened to Ramana Maharshi. Bhagavan says, in that intense fear of death happening, he had the death experience at the age of 16 in Madurai, in one of his uncle's house. When he had that intense experience, fear of death came, he just centered himself and he just witnessed. He was not shaken by that fear. And he says, suddenly I realized, even while I don't have body and mind as part of me, associated with me, I realized I exist. That consciousness, pure me, without any attachment or conditioning or association, exists. When I realized that, the fear of death disappeared, I became enlightened. You can also experience that during your jump between one state to other state. When you jump from waking to dream state, means jagrats to sapna. When you jump from sapna to sushupti, dream state to deep sleep, in all jumps, and same way from deep sleep to waking state, during all these jumps, small, on microsecond, at one moment, the door for enlightenment, the door for Turiyavastha is available to you. Whenever you unclutch, possibility to get centered exists. So now Shiva is giving you the technique to center yourself, to take the quantum jump into enlightenment during the shift of this consciousness. During the shift. Let me explain how you move from one space to other space. This understanding is called traditionally avastatraya. Avastha means states of consciousness are spaces which you experience in your day-to-day life. If you analyze and understand the avastatraya, the very understanding can lead to experience, to enlightenment, to the center of consciousness. See, you have two states of mind and two states of consciousness. One with thoughts and without thoughts. All of you know, with thoughts means now, present state. All of you have thoughts now? You know. In the deep sleep, do you have thoughts? No. So with thoughts is one space and no thoughts in the second space, second state. And same way you go through two different spaces, with the I idea and without the I idea. Now all of you have that feeling I. Understand? With I. Now you are all with the idea I. You know that you exist. But in the deep sleep, you don't know or you don't have that idea, that I. So now you have two levels of mind, with thought and without thought, two spaces of inner space, two levels of inner space, with I, without I. When all these two crisscrosses with each other, you experience four states. Please understand very clearly, with thought, with the idea I, this is called waking state. Now the state in which you are. You have thoughts and the I consciousness. The dream state is you will have thoughts, but you will not have I, because thoughts frequency will be more powerful. Understand? The frequency of thoughts will be more powerful than the I. That is why you can't control your dreams. If you can choose your own dreams, then you know what kind of dreams you will choose. In wake dream state, you can't do that. You will have thoughts, but you won't have the controlling I, the clear identity. That is why each day you will have a different identity in your dreams. Someday you will be like a college student. Someday you will be like a married person. Sometime both these few identities will mix and you will be confused. You will see, sometime you will have dreams that you are going to the college and writing exams with your wife in USA. You would have gone to college in India. You would have got married in USA. And you are working here. Maybe whatever it may be. But you will suddenly see all mixing and appearing. Means no I, only thoughts. That is dream state. And the second thing, the third thing, deep sleep state. There is neither thoughts nor I. This is called sushupti. This is jagrat. This is swapna. This is sushupti, deep sleep state. Neither thoughts exist nor that idea I exist. And the fourth state, there will be no thought, but that idea I exist will be there. That is what is called samadhi state. Understand? You live in your day-to-day life in all these three states, but you don't experience this in your life every day. But whenever you take jump from this state to this state, you will come only through this way. This is the gate. This is the gate. That is why Jesus says, I am the way. When he says, I am the way, he does not mean the person who took birth in Jerusalem and was hanged in the cross is the way. When he says, I am the way, pure I is the way. We have to understand it, the truth. We have to understand the truth. When he says, I am the way, he means the pure I without thought is the way. Whenever you move from waking state to dream state, don't think you can take direct jump. No. You have to only go through this way. Means coming to super conscious, samadhi state. Same way, from dream to deep sleep, again, you have to only come through this way. Same way, from deep sleep, whether you jump to dream or waking state, no direct road. You have to go through only samadhi state. Every time you take a jump from one state to other state, one space to other space, you go through only samadhi, super consciousness. The Western psychology would have done great service to humanity if these guys understood little bit of the samadhi or super conscious. These fools have stopped just with these three steps. And they were afraid to work on the fourth step. Literally afraid. This young fellow, Freud's disciple, goes all the way to my native place. He went all the way to my native place. He got frightened to see Ramana Maharshi and came back. He writes in his reminiscence, I am afraid if I see him, I may be completely taken away by his presence. All my vested interests, my business, research and development, everything will be proved as lie. Simple fool, not scientific. If he was a scientific person, if he was a person for knowledge, research and development, he would have had the courage, but he became a politician. Vested interests. Now really, if you stop doing research and development for your vested interests, you are a politician. or a businessman, person who is courageous enough to go behind the research and development wherever it leads, I am decided to go behind. He is seeker. This Jung, if you would have done that one step of going and meeting Ramana Maharshi and touching that fourth step, super conscious or samadhi, the whole Western psychology would have been totally different. And the West would have been helped immensely, especially with this infrastructure. If that fourth state, truth about the fourth state has been told to the West, such an immense benefit or such immense things can happen to whole humanity. These guys have stopped with this conscious, subconscious and unconscious. That is why this fellow Freud is telling that human beings are such a sick, they can't be helped. Because he has never experienced a person who has touched the fourth state. He never had an enlightened specimen. He had only all passions. All his normal people are the whom he says as his scale. All are abnormal people. See, the specimen with which he was working is all the people who are caught in sub or unconscious. Never the super conscious. They were either in the subway or in unconscious way. Neither in the, never in the super highway. They were never experienced the super conscious state. That is why so much of suffering. That is why neither the psychology nor the psychiatry or anything related to the mind created in the West is not able to solve the problems of humanity. The problems of humanity can be solved only by the knowledge and science of the super consciousness. The fourth state, Turiya. In India, the masters have not only achieved this state, they created techniques and methods to reproduce the same state in every being. They have created methods, techniques to reproduce the same experience in every being. Little bit of research on this fourth state would have really illumined or enlightened the whole West, because there are many amazing things the Western psychology has discovered and presented to the world. Many beautiful things. I was sometime, I used to wonder, how could these guys know so much about mind? Being inside the mind, usually, if you want to know about anything, you have to be a witness. You have to be away from it. If you are caught in it, you can't know the complete truth or secret. If you are away from it, you will be able to know the truth of the whole thing. But these guys, somehow they caught so much about mind without knowing about mind, without being away from the mind. I was really surprised. But they missed essential points, essential truth about this fourth state, about this, the state of enlightened one, the state of samadhi. That is why they could not accept, they could not relate with the experiences of the mystics, saints, enlightened masters. They have brushed the whole thing aside as some mental disorder. That is what they say. Many of the psychological studies or books say that there are some illusions. Some illusions. Actually, we are in illusion, not they. They are in much stronger and clear state.